నిషా కళ్ళతో నిండైన రూపంతో తెలుగు ప్రేక్షకుల నిండు హృదయాలను దోచుకున్న నిలువెత్తు అందం నికిషా పటేల్ ఇక తన తొలి చిత్రం కొమరం పులిలో తన అందంతో అభినయంతో అందరినీ ఆకట్టేసుకుంది ఇక తన మలి చిత్రం కళ్యాణరామ్ సరసన ఓంలో నటించి అందరినీ పులకింపచేసింది రీసెంట్ గా వచ్చిన అరకు రోడ్లో మూవీలో సాయిరాం శంకర్ సరసన నటించి ఇప్పుడు మన టిఎఫ్సి స్టూడియోలో ఎక్స్క్లూజివ్ గా మన కోసం ఉన్నారండి ఒక్కసారి తనతో మాట్లాడి ఆ విశేషాలు ఏంటో తెలుసుకుందాం
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Welcome to TFC Media Channels.
I'm Thank you.
Good. Moreover, after a long gap, you are doing your Arku Road Lo movie.
Correct.
How did you feel?
Arku Road Lo is my my fourth release in Telugu industry. So this is a film which is very different to what I have done so far in Telugu industry. After a long gap, I've been very busy in Tamil and. Kannada industry, so it's been quite a bit of a gap. But I've signed a few films in Telugu, so I guess you know it won't be such. You get to see me quite often now.
Your first movie you have did with Pawan Kalyan sir. Mm. How did you feel that? Like he's such a big star. Did you feel any tense or nervous? Ga emanna feel ayyara?
No. Actually, when I first came, I was really excited to meet him on the first day of set. So we didn't have a scene together on the first day of set, and. I didn't know of South industry that much because I was born and brought up as a Gujarati, obviously, right? So I knew I signed a film and I was coming to South. Everything was just super new to me, so I wasn't really nervous. I was a lot more excited than nervous, you can say.
Okay, and we came to know that you started up your career with modeling. Hmm. Modeling to start chesaru, aa tarvata films lo enter ayyaru ani telusu. Like dani gunchi emanu cheptara modeling gunchi.
Yeah, modeling for me was something that I always wanted to do. I was very slim back in the days, obviously now you can see. But modeling for me, I went on from modeling then to beauty pageants, then eventually I got in the film industry. But always since a child I wanted to become an actress. It was somewhere always there. I didn't know how to act. I didn't know how to model. I had obviously learnt it throughout my journey. But I think modeling for me, even when I came to India also, I did a lot of like print ads, I did a bit of you know, catwalks and you know, whatever it was. But that was never my goal in real life. Films was always my goal.
Okay, beauty pageants, you were the finalist, right?
Mm-hmm.
In that you were the finalist.
Correct.
Okay, you were, what, you got any like honor or something like that?
So I had for Miss Wales competition, I had won Miss Charity Wales 2006 and even though I didn't win that competition, which was for Miss World, I didn't win that competition, it never stopped me. I said, no, I failed in this miserably, I want to do. So I ended up doing Miss India UK, I did Miss Maya, and I won 5 awards and I came back. And that was enough for me. I said, you know, how much pageants can you do in life? You can do 2 or 3 and that's it. You can't become an expert and obviously your age becomes, you know.
Yes, definitely. Nikisha garu, ippadi varaku Tollywood lo meeru muggur heroes tho chesarandi. Ee hero tho meeru chaala comfortable ga unnaru.
It depends, see, because you comfort wise, you would, you know, I could be comfortable talking to Pawan Kalyan in a maybe political way or like about world problems or something. Whereas me and Sai has a relationship of just work, you know. We didn't really interact much on sets, but if we did interact, it was regarding how we're going to do our next scene. And I'm very comfortable with that because, see, an actor, when you are performing, then naturally, artists should always discuss the next scene. And with Sai garu, we always discuss our next scene, and that was the most comfortable thing that I had with him.
Okay, finally you are going to say like with Sai garu you are more comfortable than the three heroes.
No, I'm not going to say that. But I had a blast working with Sairam Shankar.
Nikisha garu, my first movie Komaram Puli chala grand ga launch chesarandi. Kani aa movie ematramu success sadinchalekapoyindi. So daniki meer ela react avtarandi?
See, when you are narrated a script to you, you don't know how the film is going to turn out, because some directors are amazing at telling scripts and it doesn't do well, or some directors are not good at telling scripts and the films become a hit. You don't know exactly what the final outcome will be like.
Meer ee failure gunchi ela feel avtunnarandi?
I don't know the reason why Komaram Puli didn't do well. But maybe it didn't suit the audience, so people didn't like it so much, or they've seen enough of it, or whatever it is. And one thing is very important for a film is when somebody goes to watch a film on a Friday or Saturday, they want to be entertained, they want to laugh, they want to become scared, they want to know what's going to happen next. And there are some directors who can deliver that and some that can't, you know, because especially when you're a director yourself, you don't know exactly how it's going to be or how it's going to. I don't have an answer for how Komarampuli didn't do well.
Komarampuli tarvata Om kuda chala pedda flop andi. Ee rendu flop la gurinchi meer ela feel avutunnaru?
No, again, I was used to. I have done almost 22 films. Almost 18 films are a disaster. So I'm so used to doing films and not reacting or not waiting or being nervous about what's going to happen after it releases. Now, Arku Rodlo is releasing on 2nd. People keep asking me how do I feel. I feel blank. Okay, 2nd it's releasing. I'll wake up in the morning. I'll have breakfast. I'll watch TV. I'll not bother. I don't want to hear how it is because people will be there to criticize.
Okay.
People will always be there to criticize and you cannot stop it. And when you are a part of a film and you're in this profession, the biggest thing you should learn is to take criticism. Because when we go and watch a film, even though we fall in love with the film, there'll still be parts that we crib about.
Nikisha garu andanga untaru, acting kuda chala baa chestaru. Mari ee movies fail avadaniki reason entandi?
For Telugu film industry, I was getting a lot of offers just for the glamorous roles, glamorous part of the film, nothing to perform, and I didn't want to go down that road. Whereas Tamil, for me, people took me in very performance-oriented roles. In Kannada industry, I did a lot of village character kind of roles. I did not just want to be, you know, the hero's mannequin or the glamorous part of a film. And a lot of these kind of offers came to me. So I think for me, that's why I said, okay, you know, I have to do good films. I have to perform. And I wanted to take that route rather than just working with stars or working because of a star cast.
నికిషా గారు చాలా కాలం తర్వాత మళ్ళీ అరకు రోడ్లో అనే మూవీతో మీరు తెలుగు ఫిల్మ్ ఇండస్ట్రీలోకి ఎంటర్ అవుతున్నారండి. మరి ఈ మూవీ హిట్ అవుతుందని కాన్ఫిడెంట్ గా ఉన్నారా?
ఐ హావ్ సీన్ ది ఫిల్మ్.
ఓకే.
అండ్ యాజ్ అ వ్యూయర్ ఐ డి నాట్ లుక్ ఎట్ మై సెల్ఫ్ యాజ్ ఓ దట్స్ మీ ఆన్ స్క్రీన్. యాజ్ అ వ్యూయర్ ఐ హావ్ గుడ్ ఎక్స్పెక్టేషన్స్ ఫర్ దిస్ ఫిల్మ్. ఇఫ్ దిస్ ఫిల్మ్ డజంట్ డు వెల్ దెన్ ఐ డోంట్ నో వాట్ పీపుల్ ఆర్ లుకింగ్ ఫర్. దెన్ ఐ గివ్ అప్ అండ్ పుట్ మై హ్యాండ్స్ అప్ అండ్ సే ఐ డోంట్ నో వాట్ యు గైస్ ఆర్ ఆల్ లుకింగ్ ఫర్ ఆర్ ఐ డోంట్ నో వాట్ యు గైస్ వాంట్ టు గో అండ్ వాచ్. What is really important about a suspense thriller is people should not know what's going to happen next. It should be scenes where people be like, oh, I wonder what's going to happen next. Oh, the scene comes and you think, oh, I didn't expect that to happen. That is what makes a film so interesting and a good film. And that, again, script, story and direction and camera work, if that combination is good together, you've got a really good product at the end of the day.
And moreover, తెలుగులో మీరు ఒక హీరోతో లవ్ లో ఉన్నారని, ఆ హీరోని పెళ్లి చేసుకోబోతున్నారని ఒక రూమర్ వచ్చింది. అది ఎంతవరకు నిజం? దేర్ ఇస్ సచ్ ఎ రూమర్. Whether it is true or not also, we need to clarify from you. It is true or not?
Like, what is not true?
No, you are going to marry some person from the industry.
No?
You are in love.
What?
Is that true?
No. How
do you got the information?
That's crap. If it was true, I would have said yes. I would have been proud of it. No, not at all. Not that I don't want to get married. I want to get married. Want to get married means like some 4 or 5 years still pending. From industry, not industry, I don't know.
Okay.
But that is a ridiculous rumor. No, no, no.
నికిషా గారు ఒక ఆడియన్ గా మీ మూవీ మీరు చూసుకున్నప్పుడు మీరు ఎలా ఫీల్ అయ్యారండి? అంటే ఆ మూవీ హిట్ అవుతుంది అనుకున్నారా? ఎలా ఫీల్ అయ్యారు?
That's what I'm saying is I've already answered your question that as a viewer, I have watched it, and as a viewer, I am saying that this film should do well. One of the plus points in the film is Sai Garu's performance and his characterization, because the director has put a lot of hard work into his characterization. Now, Sai's character is he's very innocent, naive, pavam top, you know, sort of a guy. Whereas opposite, I am completely the opposite.
Okay.
I am dominating. I'm arrogant. If I tell him to sit, he'll sit. So that combination is there, and it's gelling extremely well. Usually, in a typical film, you'll have this completely the opposite, where the hero is dominating, the heroine is like,
yes,
you know. This way, the director has done it completely different. And one thing I should say about the director is he's got a very absurd imagination. Everything in this film he's done very differently. And he's done it particularly to entertain the audience. And he's done a fabulous job at it, because nothing is common, nothing is typical, nothing is usual in this film.
Nikisha garu, ika budget vishayaniki vaste, Komarampuli kanivandi, Om kanivandi, chala high budget movies. ఇప్పుడు మీరు తీస్తున్న అరకు రోడ్లు అనేది కంపారిటివ్లీ కొంచెం లో బడ్జెట్ మూవీ అండి. మీరు ఏమైనా గిల్టీగా ఫీల్ అవుతున్నారా?
నో 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 నో. సీ, బడ్జెట్ వెన్ ఇట్ కమ్స్ టు ఎ ఫిల్మ్ ఇస్ ఇట్ డిపెండ్స్ సీ, బికాజ్ వెన్ యూ ఆర్ హావింగ్ అ బిగ్ స్టార్ కాస్ట్ ఆటోమేటిక్లీ ద బడ్జెట్ విల్ గో అప్. Or when you're having different locations, or when you're having these certain things, making a film is not because you have a big budget the film will be amazingly well, or having a small budget the film will not do well, not at all, nothing like that at all. It's just budget comes to how much, you know, that is the producer's thing. That's got nothing to do with an artist. We don't even ask how much the budget is of the film.
వరుసగా రెండు మూవీస్ తెలుగులో చేశారండి, ఆ తర్వాత మలయాళంలోకి తమిళ్లోకి ఎంటర్ అయిపోయారు. అంటే టాలీవుడ్ ఫిల్మ్ ఇండస్ట్రీని ఎందుకు వదిలేశారండి?
ఐ హావ్ నాట్ లెఫ్ట్ తెలుగు ఇండస్ట్రీ, దట్ ఈస్ ద ఫస్ట్ థింగ్. ఐ హావ్ ట్రై టు మేనేజ్ టు వర్క్ ఇన్ కన్నడా, తమిళ్, తెలుగు సైమల్టేనియస్లీ, అండ్ ఈవెన్ మలయాళం ఫర్ దట్ ఫ్యాక్ట్. ఐ సైన్డ్ అ ఫిల్మ్ విత్ మామూటి కాల్డ్ న్యూస్ మేకర్ విచ్ డిడెంట్ రియలీ టేక్ ఆఫ్, అండ్ ఐ గాట్ అనౌన్స్ ఫర్ ఫిల్మ్ విత్ పృథ్వీరాజ్ ఆల్సో విచ్ డిడెంట్ టేక్ ఆఫ్. And for Telugu industry, for me though, is something that's very, very close to my heart, because Kamrampuli was my first film. I got introduced here and I have immaculately just missed Telugu industry so much. And I still wish to work here, and I am working here. So it's not like I've left Telugu industry for other industries, not at all. This is my first industry, I'll always remember it.
తెలుగులో మీ మూవీస్ హిట్ కానందు వల్లే మీరు టాలీవుడ్ ఫిల్మ్ ఇండస్ట్రీని వదిలేశారు అనుకోవచ్చా?
ఐ థింక్ దిస్ ఇస్ ఎ వెరీ బ్యాడ్ బిలీఫ్ హియర్ దట్ ఇఫ్ అ హీరోయిన్ డజన్ డూ వెల్ ఇన్ అ ఫ్యూ ఫిల్మ్స్ యు నో ఐరన్ లెగ్ ఆర్ షీ మైట్ బ్రింగ్ దట్ బ్యాడ్ లక్ టు అవర్ ఫిల్మ్ వాట్ ఎవర్ ఇట్ ఈస్. ఐ థింక్ ఇట్స్ రిడిక్యులస్ బికాస్ ఎవ్రీబడి హ్యాస్ ఫెయిలియర్స్ ఇన్ లైఫ్, ఎవ్రీబడి హ్యాస్ సక్సెస్ ఇన్ లైఫ్. సక్సెస్ మైట్ కమ్ ఆఫ్టర్ యువర్ సిక్స్త్ ఫిల్మ్, సిక్స్త్, సెవెంత్ ఫిల్మ్, సెకండ్ ఫిల్మ్, మైట్ ఈవెన్ కమ్ ఇన్ యువర్ ఫస్ట్ ఫిల్మ్. వీ డోంట్ నో. ఐ డోంట్ బిలీవ్ ఇన్ డెస్టినీ, ఐ డోంట్ బిలీవ్ ఇన్ లక్. సో ఐ షుడ్ సే దట్ ఐ డెంట్ లీవ్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ దట్ రీజన్. ఐ డెంట్ గెట్ ద రైట్ ఆఫర్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ దట్. అండ్ యు నో దిస్ టూ మచ్ ఆఫ్ దట్ దట్ బిలీవ్ దట్ పీపుల్ హ్యావ్ హియర్. సో యూ జస్ట్ టెన్ టు థింక్ దట్ ఓకే, ఇఫ్ పీపుల్ ఆర్ నాట్ ready to take you in such films, then why would you stick around? You can't always wait for films to be. You have to move on in life, and that's to anybody in any profession. If there's not opportunities there for you, move on. Opportunities from that place will always come back to you.
Nikisha garu, iron leg ane comment ochindandi, meer ela feel avtaru?
I found it, I didn't even know what an iron leg was. I had to Google it. People have never called me an iron leg, but because Kamrampuli didn't do well, before Kamrampuli, I had a lot of offers with Nagarjuna sir, Venkatesh sir, Ravi Teja, Mahesh Babu's Kaleja came to me. So many films came to me, but I think unfortunately that time, you know, dates or certain other things or whatever it was. But after that film released, I didn't really get so many offers that I was expecting. And things turned around at that point. So when I wanted films, it never came to me. When I didn't want films, it came to me. So
Nikisha garu, you are basically from a Gujarati family andi. Hyderabad vachaka aa tradition ee tradition emaina change kanipinchindandi meeku?
I don't think any tradition is different. When India comes to India, everybody celebrates Diwali. We just have these small beliefs which go into a little more depth, which we all celebrate in different religions. I personally am not, I am a Gujarati by blood because my mother and father are, but I have never believed in religion. I have never believed in religion. I just see human as a human person. It's been with me since years. Even if somebody says to me, are you Gujarati? It doesn't make sense to me. I just turn around and I say yes. But I have, whenever I felt that there is a celebration going on, let it be like any South Indian celebration, let it be Gujarati celebration or Punjabi celebration, I always tend to get involved with it. I've always been to, you know, Gurudwaras, I've been to temples, I've been to mosques, I've been to churches, I've been everywhere. So I don't have a particular belief. If you actually look at it, okay, the same belief is just a different name. So
Nikisha garu, meeru CCL cricket league lo Chennai ki support chesarandi, Telugu team ki enduku support cheyaledu?
What is the reason? What might be the reason?
2 years I supported Telugu team. After that, when I had a bit of a gap, they didn't invite me to support that team. So I had got invited from Kannada team because I started working there. So I was supporting Kannada team for 2 years and then Chennai team for 2 years. If you don't get an invite from that team, how can you go, is my question. So you can't just turn up and sit there. It's not right. So it's just that you invited from a team, which actually when you are invited from a team, that actually means that you're invited from all the industries. Like there's actresses like Priyamani was the ambassador for CCL. Okay. She's worked in Kannada, Tamil, Telugu. Okay. She's been all over. But she's not like she's supporting one team particularly. That's the same with my case also. So even if I am with the Chennai team, I've always made an effort to go and say hello to the Telugu team, even the Karnataka Bulldozers, which is there. So because you know everybody from the industry, and CCL is a place where all industries come together and just have a blast, that's all.
Nikisha Garu, Arku Road lo movie gunchi ani cheptarandi.
Arku Road lo is releasing on 2nd of December. It's probably one of the best suspense thrillers I have seen so far. In a very long time in the South industry. It's a film that you should not miss. I've not said that about any of my films till date. This is the first time I'm saying it. The whole team is young. The director, Vasu, is a new director, but he's put his hard work of, you know, 2 years that he's visualized in this film, and the film has turned out to be extremely well. There's four producers in this film who are absolutely crazy about the Telugu film industry. So they have come and made this film, and we have Jagdish as the cameraman, who did Nayaki with Trisha, and he's done a fabulous job in this film, and he's a young guy, and the whole team is very young. And of course Sai Garu, he's a fantastic actor. So this whole team together has come, and the product has come out extremely well. The 2nd December, I expect you all to see the film, and if you don't see the film, don't talk to me.
ఈ మూవీలో ఏమైనా ఫన్నీ ఇన్సిడెంట్స్, మెమరబుల్ ఇన్సిడెంట్స్ ఏమైనా ఉన్నాయండి?
There was a lot of the scenes which I didn't understand because the director had a lot of different visualizations, and I was like a bit, you know. So there's a Suhagrat scene, which is the end of the film. And the costume guy, his name was, I think his name was Pandey or something like that. He came to the caravan and he said, "Ma'am, this is your costume." And I looked at the costume, and the costume was the top of a police outfit and like a lungi below. So I said, "Okay, so you've changed the scene." He was like, "No, we're doing the Suhagrat scene." So I said, "So okay, so you'll give me like a nice sari." No. The director wants you to wear the top of a police costume and bottom thing. So I was like, "Are you sure this is not a joke?" So he said, "No, it's not a joke. This is what you want me to do." I said, "I actually wore that. So in the Suhagrat scene, I have a police costume, lungi with a stick, and a cap. If you see that, it's actually quite hilarious."
And a different costume vesukunnaru anamata.
So that was probably because we laughed so hard for like an hour. Everybody looked at me on set and they just could not stop laughing. We could not do the scene. It took us almost 2 hours just to complete the whole scene. So it's a very memorable scene.
So such a different costume for your
yeah, who wears that in a Suhaga? I mean, seriously.
'When I got narrated
this script, he wanted a character just like how I was in Komaram Pooli, and he couldn't seem to find or visualize anybody else. So I'd been in talks with this film for almost a year. You know, we would discuss on a lot of things and everything. And after Komaram Pooli, I didn't want to do a police costume. How many offers came to me with a police cop, international cop, you know, constable, this, that, and everything. And we'll make it different, blue costume, whatever it was. And I was just very bored, and I didn't want to do anything that got related to being a police officer. So with the director, when he narrated the script, our first day on set, I came and I said, "Vasu, how do you want me to perform this scene?" He said, he just stood and he looked at me and said, "I don't want you to act. I want you to be yourself."
Okay.
So I thought, okay, but this character is very dominating and she's like very arrogant. He said, "Yeah, I want you to be yourself." I said, "So what are you trying to say? I'm like arrogant or dominating or what?" He's like, "Sort of, just be yourself." So I have been myself in that movie. And that is a relationship that we had. He would explain to Sai Garu how he wants the scene. He never explained to me because he wanted me to do things my way. So
meeru maatladin danni batti chuste telugu e matramu nechukunnattu ga ledandi. So endukani?
The reason for that is because I had a gap in Telugu. I was working in Tamil. Every time I go for an interview or every time I'm on set, people ask me the same question, "Why didn't you learn Tamil?" Then suddenly I will be shooting in Tamil industry for a week. Next I'll be going to Kannada industry. People ask, why you not learned Kannada? Same when I come here, people are like, why you not learn Telugu? How can a person learn three languages at one go without making a mistake? There was times where I went to Chennai and I spoke Kannada and people got offended. There was times when I got confused, I went to Kannada, I mean to Kannada industry, started speaking Tamil. So I decided, okay, you know, one language after one language after one. So I eventually learned a bit of Tamil, a bit of Kannada industry. But now Telugu industry for me, because I'm back and I'm doing Guntur talkies now, I'm doing 100 degree Celsius remake Malayalam, which is being in Tamil and Telugu. And we have Leela releasing here also. Now Aruku Roadlo is releasing. So now that I'm going to be constantly working in Telugu industry, I will start learning Telugu. I promise. Promise, 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 promise.
తెలుగులో ఏవో నాలుగు పదాలు నేర్చుకున్నాను అన్నారు కదండి, ఒక్కసారి మా వ్యూయర్స్ కోసం చెప్తారా?
ఐ మీన్ బాగునారా, యు నో ద టిపికల్ వర్డ్స్ విచ్ యు ఆర్ యూజింగ్, ఎలా ఉన్నారు బాగునారా, విచ్ యు నో లెర్న్ ఆన్ ఎ డైలీ బేసిస్.
నికిషా గారు, హౌ ఇస్ యువర్ కోఆర్డినేషన్ విత్ సాయిరామ్ శంకర్?
హి వాస్ వెరీ కంఫర్టబుల్ టు వర్క్ విత్. లైక్ ఐ సెడ్ టు యు బిఫోర్, వి వుడ్ ఆల్వేస్ డిస్కస్ ది సీన్ అండ్ దట్ వాస్ ది మోస్ట్ కంఫర్టబుల్ పార్ట్. అండ్ I didn't actually know that he was going to stutter. He has a character where he stutters throughout the whole film. I didn't know he was going to do that throughout the whole film. But the most amazing thing about him is when action happens, he just becomes into his character. When cut happens, he becomes normal. And that's really difficult for an actor to do. So for me, he's a very hardworking person. And I think he's done a fabulous job in this film. Words cannot explain so much. When you go and watch the film, you'll be able to understand what I'm actually talking about.
Telugulo mee future projects entani?
So I'm doing in Telugu now, Aruku Roadlo will release, and we have Leela, which is a trilingual film, which is going to release very soon. That's also completed. After this, I have Guntur Talkies sequel starting, and also after that, we have 100 degrees Celsius remake, which is a Malayalam film. Which is me and Lakshmi Rai, Tamil and Telugu film, which is directed by Mithrin Jawar.
Guntur Talkies 2 lo mee role entandi, ante main lead meere chestunnara?
So I am doing for Guntur Talkies, as of now I am doing Rashmi's character and Sunny Leon is doing Shraddha Das's character.
Nikisha bayta ela untundandi, bubbly ga untunna?
I'm always in my own world, I'm always observing people.
Okay.
I used to be a very bubbly girl, you know, full of life and everything, and now I've just become very dull because I've seen it all, and sometimes I get very fed up of life. Don't know where I'm going, don't know what I'm doing. I wake up at 2 o'clock in the afternoon. I sleep at 5 o'clock in the morning.
Okay.
So
Nikisha garu, ippudu varaku vachina meeku best compliments entandi?
I think people always one person said, oh, you're actually really tall. So I'm very height conscious. And that day I was wearing a gown, or it was a sari, and I had these really huge heels on, and I love looking tall. On screen I look very tall, in person I am actually just 5'4". And even some people, like if I'm walking to the airport, I remember one guy said to me, said, ma'am, are you Nikisha Patel? I'm like, yes. He said, but you're so tall in films. And I was really upset. My whole flight for like 1 or 2 hours, it kept running through my head, and I was really, really upset. I wanted to ask the person sitting next to me, do you think I'm short? Do you think I'm tall? But I thought, no, that would be a little over the top. But one person said, oh, you're actually very, very tall. I didn't expect you to look this tall. And I didn't want to lie to that person, say I'm wearing heels and all. I was like, yeah, I'm tall. Of course I'm tall. I look tall. I am tall. My grandfather's 6'1". My grandfather's not 6'1". But I felt really good for the next couple. I was walking like a supermodel that time, I remember. After that compliment, oh God.
మీకు ఇండస్ట్రీ నుంచి కానివ్వండి, బయట నుంచి కానివ్వండి, ఎవరైనా ప్రపోజ్ చేశారా?
ఐ దేర్ వాస్ అ టైమ్, ఐ హావ్ అ స్టోరీ దట్ మై మమ్ సిస్టర్, షీస్ ఆల్వేస్ బీన్ వెరీ ఫాండ్ ఆఫ్ గెటింగ్ మీ మ్యారీడ్, అండ్ ఐ వాస్ అట్ అ హౌస్ వన్స్ మై పేరెంట్స్ వర్ ఇన్ వేల్స్ అండ్ దే డోంట్ రియలీ బాదర్ విత్ మై మ్యారేజ్. షీ సెడ్, యు నో, దేర్స్ అ గాయ్ అండ్ హీస్ అ రియలీ గుడ్ గాయ్, యూ షుడ్ మీట్ హిమ్ అండ్ దిస్ అండ్ దట్ అండ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్. అండ్ ఐ వాస్ వెరీ యంగ్ అండ్ ఐ సెడ్, ఐ డోంట్ వాంట్ టు గెట్ మ్యారీడ్ అండ్ ఐ డోంట్ వాంట్ టు మీట్ హిమ్, ఐ సెడ్. అండ్ ఐ వాస్ థింకింగ్, హౌ డు ఐ? షీస్ లైక్, నో, దే ఆర్ కమింగ్ అట్ 7 o'clock, యూ షుడ్ మీట్ హిమ్, ఇస్ అ వెరీ స్వీట్ గాయ్ అండ్ దట్. Because I'll show you a photo. I said, no, I do not want to meet him because I'm too young for this, you know. So I was thinking, how do I avoid now this meeting? Because I'm in a house and I don't go out. So I thought, okay, fine. So I said, okay, Indian tradition, when a guy comes home, okay, the guy will ask girls questions. You know, do you cook? What do you cook? What do you study? And this and that. So I said, now it's 2000 and whatever it was. I think it was 2011. I said, now it's 2011. Now girls will ask guys also, right?
Yes.
She's like, yeah. Why? I said, because I will also ask questions to him. She said, what will you ask? I said, I will ask him, do you also cook? Do you know how to do dishes? Do you know how to do jadu pocha just in case my maid doesn't come? Then what? So she was like, oh my God, no, 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 let's not call him. Let's not call him. You just lock her in the room. Otherwise, just don't call her out or just tell them that, you know, we're busy today. Tell them not to come. So ever since then, I've just avoided all these things in my family.
My first movie, Komaram Pulilo, meeru Pavan Kalyan gar venta padutu untaru. Ante tanni padeyadaniki try cheyadam kani vendi ala. So meeru bayata kuda alantive emaina chesara?
I have never ran after a guy. I was never interested.
So no crushes for you?
I've had crushes. I had so many crushes. I still have I still have crushes right now. Coming to the industry, there's only one hero that I had a huge crush on, and that was Tiger Shroff. When he first came into Hero Panti, I was a huge fan of him. I actually went to watch the film. My manager said, you should watch this film. It's a good film. It's a remake of a Telugu film. I went to watch the film, and the minute I saw him come on screen and all that fighting, you know, the six pack, and I was like, wow. I found the kind of husband that I wanted in my life.
అంటే డేట్ చేయడానికి వీలుంటే టైగర్ ష్రాఫ్ తో గానీ నాగార్జునతో గానీ వెళ్తారా?
నో, వాట్ ఐ మీన్ బై టైగర్ ష్రాఫ్ ఇస్ ఆన్ స్క్రీన్.
ఓకే.
ఇన్ హీరో పంతి ఐ వాస్ హ్యూజ్ ఫ్యాన్ ఆఫ్ హిస్ క్యారెక్టర్ అండ్ జస్ట్ హిమ్. ఐ యామ్ నాట్ గోనా ఆన్సర్ దట్ క్వశ్చన్. మైట్ నాట్. ఐ నాట్ టెల్లింగ్ యు.
ఇఫ్ యు గెట్ ఎ ఛాన్స్ టు గో.
అంటే నాగార్జున గారిని ఎప్పుడు కలవలేదా? మీ ఫీలింగ్ ఎక్స్ప్రెస్ చేయలేదా?
ఐ హాడ్ ఎ హ్యూజ్ క్రష్ ఆన్ నాగార్జున సర్ వెన్ ఐ వాస్ లిటిల్.
ఓకే.
అండ్ huge crush on him. Every time I see him now, I always blush, like, hello, how are you? And he's a sweetheart. I'm talking to his Telugu film industry. I used to watch Criminal, Hindi film, which he did with Manisha Koirala a lot. I used to love his songs. He used to constantly play on the radio when we were young, in London I'm talking about. And I watched Criminal so many times. I used to come back from school and just put on Criminal, eat my food and just keep watching. So I think Nagarjuna sir for South industry, and for Hindi I was always fond of Tiger Shroff, and that the list ends there. No, no, I've never told him that. That would be really embarrassing for him. Okay. But I've met him many times. I mean, you have to have that respect obviously in the industry.
Nikisha garu, mee chetike edo gayamainattuga undandi, adi enti ento telusukochcha?
I don't cook, unfortunately. I boil rice.
Okay.
And I still burn it. This is from my tongs. So I'm constantly curling. You always see me in curly hair, right? See, this hard work and effort is from tonging my hair. So
his mistake.
No, this is just, no, this is not his. It's me. I was tonging my hair. So
okay.
Okay. Yeah.
Nikisha garu, mee kante andamaina ammayini chusinappudu meer eppudaina jealous ga feel ayyara?
Of course. I never found, but of course I always feel jealous.
Okay.
No, I'm joking. No, we admire women. Women have a very bad habit. The minute you see a good-looking girl, you'll never look at her in front, but the minute she turns around, you will look at her and stare at her for like 2 minutes. I do it all the time. I've always been very fond of Anushka Shetty.
Okay.
I think the minute she smiles,
okay,
everybody just like, you know, just,
yes,
yeah. She's very beautiful. And even Lakshmi Rai's face, she's got a very beautiful face.
Yes.
And there's lots I can think about, but.
Nikisha garu, how far you are active in mall openings?
Yeah, I've been for so many shop openings, like so many years back, and too many shop openings is not good because there's a lot of competitive brands. But it was, shop openings was a really good, fast experience for me. You know, you get to interact with the crowd, you get to interact with the audience, and you get to see, you know, what kind of brands are out there and stuff. It's a good experience.
Parties ki, pubs ki velthu untarandi?
I do party quite often in Britain. In India, I've cut it down a lot because I am like 28 now. So as you get older, you're bored of it, you know. I've had my fair bit of share when I was young. I think there's this really bad mentality here, is that partying is really bad, and you know, girls should not go or shouldn't wear such things or do such things. But for me, you know, we live once. By the time you're 60, 70, you regret it. you'll all regret it. So if you know, you should take my advice and at least pop down a bar and see what it's like.
So pubbings ni chaala enjoy chestuntar anamata.
I do. I enjoy it. Do you party?
Of course.
Everybody parties.
No, how far you are more active? Like it depends. Like.
No. I used to be very hyper when I was young. Now I just go and I chill. I listen to music, get away from the world. I've stopped partying. I don't like it so much anymore. So now my strategy is sometimes, you know, when I want to de-stress, I get out of India or I get out of Britain and I just go. I just backpack, and sometimes I go alone. Sometimes I go with friends. But sometimes you want to just get away from work, life, industry, people, and you just go and you stay quiet for 3-4 days until you just don't talk to anybody. So it's me.
Nikisha garu, meeru mee body ni chaala baa maintain chestunnarandi. Konni beauty tips maa viewers kosam.
So before, my diet for the past 5 years used to be lots of cheese, butter, ghee, biryani, anything that was fattening. In the past 2 months for Guntur Talkies, I have been losing weight. So I've lost almost 5.5 kgs. I've been on a ketosis diet, which is high fats, high protein, and zero carbs. So I can actually eat cheese, I can eat butter, high proteins, but zero carbs means you should not even eat a single tiny bit of rice or anything that comes across to you. You should be very careful, no sugar and all that. And I've lost a lot of weight for that. But my main reason that I've lost is because of gymming and working hard, I guess. And I don't like gymming, I hate it. But yeah, heavy, you know, weight lifting and everything. And the day I get married, none of this. I'm so happy. I'm going to eat so much food and become so fat. I can't wait.
Nikisha garu, you are maintaining a very good physique andi. My diet secret enti?
My beauty tips.
Yes, yes. What are the suggestions you are going to give for
the
young girls?
There's no suggestion. It's just, people think I look good because, and I'll tell you the secret behind that. But as long as you don't tell anybody, it's because of just makeup, nothing else. There's no other beauty tips, no facial, no scrubbing, no mask, nothing. It is just makeup, there's nothing else. If you see me without makeup, you will walk straight past me, you will not even recognize me.
Glamour kosam, konni beauty tips ma viewers kosam istarandi.
People say fashion and beauty and all this crap, let me just say. You open a magazine, so whatever is written in the magazine or that model you have in the front cover, people seem to think it's in trend. But it's not. What if you put a person who is a little overweight on, started putting it on front cover of magazines? Suddenly that will become trend. So it is nothing about what beauty tips or what is good and being fair or being. I like dark skin. So, you know, trends always keep changing, you know, things always keep changing. When I was young, I had blonde hair and I used to go to the tanning salon. I didn't like being fair. So everybody has their own beauty tips, so however they feel they look young, but I don't have any beauty tips.
Okay.
Nikisha garu, what is the most toughest moment in your life, Andy?
I think in the industry, my happiest moment is when people appreciate my work or my films and appreciate that, okay, I've done quite a bit. I've done 22 films in the last 6 years. So I feel very appreciated at that point. And apart from the industry, you know, some of my happiest moments, my most happiest moment is when I go back for Christmas every year to see my family. It is a time of the year, like I'm smiling already because it's a month away, but we are not Christians, but we celebrate Christmas quite a lot. I mean, to the extent to that, you know, everything that a Christian is supposed to do, we do. So it's just that moment when you're with your family and you get to just catch up on that whole year and just be together and fight and love each other and do whatever you want to do, and you know. But my saddest moments is, I guess, out of the industry is when I'm away from them. I Skype my mother every day. I Skype my father every day. So when I put the phone on, I always think, you know, I missed out on a lot so many years and I should have been with them, and I feel quite upset that way. And
Nikisha garu, what is the most sad moment in your life?
Industry-wise, I don't really get upset. Nothing at all, no.
For more celebrity interviews and other interesting videos, please subscribe to TFC Media Channels.
Hi, this is Nikisha Patel. For more film updates, please subscribe to TFC Media Channel please subscribe.